My name's Dave Mayhood, and I'm an aquatic ecologist. These days, I'm primarily working with Westlope cutthroat trout and bull trout. I work on all sorts of fish and aquatic invertebrates and the physical and chemical aspects of water. Why should we care about the ecological health of our public land? We rely on them for our life. Essentially, we cannot live without natural ecosystems and their natural functioning. They create the air that we breathe, the oxygen that we need. It's the living ecosystems that keep us alive on this planet. There's no other planet, certainly within a distance that we could reach, that could support us. And as far as we know, this is the only place in the universe that can support us. This place created us. We cannot, literally cannot live without it. I started really hiking, fishing, and camping when I was about 14 years old. We would just drive out into the forest on some extremely rough roads, find a place to camp. We'd never see anybody for 2 or 3 days at a time. The forests were complete. There would be a few clear cuts, an occasional burn area, but primarily it was forest. But you could drink directly out of creeks and not get sick. You can't do that anymore. Over the years, I've noticed that our public lands have really deteriorated to a considerable degree. And I'm thinking primarily here of the eastern slopes. Not only can you not drink relatively clean water out of the creeks, but when you look in the creek bottoms, they're covered with drifts of silt. And that silt comes from somewhere. It comes from primarily a very dense road network, roads and trails that are used by resource extraction companies, logging companies, and all sorts of other uses. These are basically a geomorphic form that this land has never seen before. And it's developed in the last 50 to 75 years in a big way. We are doing a number of things. We're creating huge access for the public to wildlife, which tends to be a very bad thing for wildlife because it exposes them to basically human predation as well as human disturbance, and their habitat is disturbed. And so we're seeing many populations, wildlife populations, that are at risk. When you have roads and trails into an area, particularly in the dense nature that we have here, it's very easy to fish out a stream, for example, or to overexploit the stream. We need to realize that when we change something in our environment, we're affecting not just that one location or that one thing that we changed. And the reason that we get into so much trouble, I think, with land use issues is because we tend not to think the ecological way, that everything is connected to everything else. When we push on something, we need to look further down the road and see where that push is going to be felt besides the location we made the push. It's almost impossible to conceive of how you would do fundamental ecological research relying strictly on private lands. Private lands have to make money for some people, or they have to support people, other people in other ways, and they're almost always modified in order to do so. But we need to understand how the natural system works so that we know how to deal with the land when we have to manage it. And for that, we need large tracts of relatively unmodified landscape. And that is available only in public lands, not just national parks or provincial parks, but just wildlands generally, for example, the forest reserves. And so that's why it's so critical for us to manage them and maintain them in as reasonably a natural state as possible.